All right, so this is now the Q learning equation again, which again is one of these alpha based things. And just to be clear, I really do mean, you know, alpha sub t here, that we're doing this over time, we're updating our learning rates as we go. It's just sometimes it's a little irritating to put that there. But yeah, so let's imagine that we're doing that. We're using that same kind of weighted process, bumping the values around. So what would, based on what we just talked about, Charles, what would this actually be computing?
Well, it would be computing the average value that you would get for following, you know, a kind of optimal policy after you take this particular action.
Yeah, that is trying to go to this expected value. And what is that expected value? So the linearity of expectation says that we can actually move the expectation, break up the sum using the expectation. So this, the expected value of the reward is actually R of S.
Mm-hmm.
The gamma is going to come out because of the linearity of expectation. And now what we're left with is the expectation over all next states of the maximum estimated value of the estimated Q value of the next state. But what is this distribution over S prime? It's the distribution that is determined by the transition function.
Right.
So it's this, which is, you know, this. So that's good. I'm kind of cheating, though. Do you see how I'm cheating?
I think I know you're cheating, but tell me.
Well, so when I told the story about this alpha arrow updating thing, I said that it converges to the expected value of this quantity here.
Mm-hmm.
But this quantity here, since it's Q hat, it's actually changing over time.
Right.
So this target is actually a moving target. It's changing over time. So we can't quite do this analysis because the first step is a little bit questionable. But it turns out that there really is a theorem that this simple update rule, this Q learning update rule, this tiny little one line of code actually solves Markov decision processes.
Yeah.